Yeah, it's recording.
Thank you.
Good, the gate?
Yeah.
All right, right behind you. Good. How about yourself?
Good.
Self.
Good.
All right. Ah, Derek.
I'm Robert.
Nice to meet you. So you're gonna redo this whole thing? The break there?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's gonna do a cinder block wall.
Mm-hmm.
Right here on the sidewall. Gain a couple feet, I think.
Mm-hmm.
On his RV access. So I've got all this already sold.
Now,
working on the vinyl,
Are these set over 2x4s or do you know?
Nope.
Or excuse me, over 4x4s are just...
Nope, they're hollow. When he installed them, they're in, you can kind of see, you know those tubes, those concrete?
The cone?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know, so, yeah.
So, and then he's got
here blocks.
A couple sacks of concrete in each one, and most of this is surrounded by gravel.
Oh, okay.
This gravel, he said, was pretty thick. So, these, depending on how much work you want to do, I mean, they may be salvageable, because once all this block is out, the gravel's just going to collapse.
Right.
You know, and then there's not going to be much holding. They might just come out really easy. You'll just have the concrete still around it.
Here. You know?
But the tubes are, like, probably that big. So...
You're talking about the cones. I'm thinking of the piers, the kind of pyramid shape here. You're talking about the cones where you set the little yellow ones down in the ground and they just pour down into them. And these are set down inside of that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Probably 24 inches. So, it's a possibility that you might be able to reuse the posts. You just dig a larger hole and then set the whole tube. And then pour more concrete around that.
Right.
I don't know if you can ship the concrete off. Or if it's even, you know, that's why I just said, whatever you can salvage.
I get what you're saying. The thing, you know, of course, what I was asking at first was like, say, I really just need the gate.
Yeah.
And it's exactly the same thing I'm creating in RBX. I used to have a solid cinder wall on the side of my house.
Oh, really?
And I took that down, and so I just got to put a gate over there.
Okay.
You know, I can find me a good use, gate, then I can save me a bunch of money, and then I'll make the new wall conform to that. And so I don't really need the panels at all, though. I was thinking, well, crap, I can get them to sell them myself, not a big doggone deal.
Yeah, because I have quite a few people call,
and uh-huh.
I've already had other people come out here and say, oh, yeah, we'll come and get them. We want them after the wall is...
After the thing is gone?
After the... blocks are all out of the way. I'm like, well, cool. Well, leave me a deposit so I know you're serious, and I'll take the ad off. And they're like, no, just call me. I'm like, dude, I'm getting so many calls, I'm not going to remember your number. So you call me if you're still interested.
Hello. I hear you.
There's 10 of them.
10 of them. Okay.
10 panels, not counting the gate. Okay. So 6 feet each, so it's like 60 feet of that back one.
Right. Yeah,
I have a tape measure if you.
I got one.
But yeah, they are 6. He had another retaining wall right there.
Mm-hmm.
And I took all of them. My house. So I have last time remodeled
right there,
I got a black block.
What is the work with, though?
All the blocks there.
Mm-hmm.